my God, what does the quick start button do?
The quick start button starts the game faster.
Does it just rocket you into a game?
It just rockets you into a game.
That's such a fun idea.
I bet because I'm recording the desktop, you were able to see that thing with my volume.
Yep. Your volume slider totally visible in this
Everyone
LP.
Can see it.
And it's full LP of Enter the Gungeon.
It's not a full LP of Enter. Well,
we're going to finish the game.
Depending on your definition of full LP and game.
Is this a game?
It's a game.
Oh, I heard it was worth
processing. So there was an evil fortress, and then a giant bullet hit it. A giant space bullet.
Shot from a giant space gun?
I guess. And then it was brought to ruin, but then it's still cool because it's an evil dungeon. You know how it is.
Yeah, it seems like bullets are a big deal around these parts.
They're big on that shit. And then the bullets are praying to a gun.
A gun that can kill the past.
Isn't that a great concept?
It's great. It's a good idea.
I love it. You can erase all your mistakes and kill the past.
Oh, I like that hill. He's kind of neutral, but he's not super happy.
So somehow evil bullets over time rebuilt the fortress.
The legend would risk everything for another shot. I like all those little target reticles on the side.
You get it? Because guns.
Because guns.
This game is obsessed with guns.
Is this like your favorite game now?
No, but it's absurd. So let's just let this roll in.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice. There's lyrics.
Yeah, I really like the lyrics. So Liam, let's get going.
All right. So okay, that wasn't what I was expecting. So here's the character select.
Here's your character select.
Okay.
You have four characters.
Yeah, I remember these people from the art. And is that like a merchant over there or?
No, that's the co-op guy.
Oh, I see. Okay. So, who's the most normal?
The most normal is the Marine.
The Marine?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
All right, so, they all have very slightly different handguns that you start with.
Yeah.
And they all have little bonuses. So, okay. if you go over the Marine, the helmet is that he starts with a point of armor.
Right.
He gets a walkie-talkie that lets him call in ammo once. And that book is he shoots faster and reloads faster than the other guys.
Right.
The pilot has a lockpick that can sometimes open up chests. He has more storage space for ammunition, and he gets better prices at the shop.
Okay, that's a big deal.
The convict starts with two guns.
The shotgun, I see that.
Has a Molotov cocktail, which is a decent weapon, and she gives out more damage after she's been hurt.
Okay.
And the hunter starts with two guns again. The crossbow.
And she has a dog.
The crossbow is really fantastic to kill enemies with. It's one of the
which
better
I imagine starters. Is why she only has three items.
Yeah, and the dog will occasionally find hidden items for you after you've
really
beaten
good.
A room. But the most normal is the Marine by far.
Okay, I'm gonna take the Marine just to give it a swing.
Yep. So your controls are pretty simple.
Oh, I'm already in. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Left trigger is your dodge roll.
Oh, you can fall off. Okay, yeah. That's important.
Left trigger is your dodge roll. Your dodge roll is explicitly explained to you that you... Oh, that's the tutorial dungeon.
Okay,
we can ignore that. Your dodge roll is you're in the air, you're invincible. You hit the ground, you're not.
Okay.
Right trigger is to shoot your gun.
Okay.
The analog sticks are to move and aim your gun.
Okay.
X will reload.
Mm-hmm.
And RB is use item.
Okay.
Like your special item, and LB is pull up the mat.
Okay, I'm sure I'll be fine.
If you pull up the mat, there's
that's so cute.
There's a million teleporter symbols all over the map. You can hit LB and just scroll with the right analog stick and just click on them unlocked them.
Okay, cool.
And that's it.
Neat.
You can also hold a right trigger to shoot your guns.
Okay, I see.
So the armor, like, it seems to pop a hit off of you.
Yeah, basically.
When you've actually, it'll blow up the bullets, and those guys explode. So, you've cleared it, and now you can teleport back there at any time.
Okay, so these are the teleporters, basically?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're little gun things. So I've been playing this for...
Yeah, it seems like you played it a little bit. Do you ever find items under these things? Or?
No, never.
Okay.
Never, ever.
Okay, good rule.
There's a shit ton of dudes, and it's basically like a bullet hell roguelike, which I thought I would really hate, but I gave it a shot anyway. And there's like, I'm not sure that I love it, right? But
there's a certain quality.
I certainly
about their gun admiration.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of guns. Like if you hit select right now.
I always like that in there.
You can go into the Ammunomicon.
Oh, sick.
And you can scroll down to the guns and just go.
Wow.
If they're colored in, that means I've
seen
them.
And then the gray ones are...
Gray ones are ones that can be gotten in game right now.
And question mark, you're not
far
enough yet.
And question marks are not far enough yet. I never got to where they're at.
The microtransaction gun. Yeah. Pay to win semi-automatic. Everyone involved in the production of this gun thought it was a bad idea, but the higher-ups made them build it anyway.
That
later gun. Management shut down that gun factory for making a gun no one liked.
So that gun comes with the collector's edition.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah.
Nice. Machine gun wash only. Fires t-shirts.
Yeah, no, there's a million of them, and there's also a shit ton of items in the tab underneath that they do all sorts of weird goofy stuff.
Right.
So I found one that gives you active reloads, and it's a cog.
I was wondering if there was active reloads.
There's
yeah.
cigarettes, and I'm not sure what those do, but nice. They're hazardous to your health. Hegemony credits you can see in the upper right. That's for like consistent upgrades.
Right.
That stay between runs, and I've rescued a couple people. From the Gungeon, and they stuck around. So like, there's a new guy in the shop, and there's a
I like these designs.
Yeah, and it only shows the bosses that you've beaten.
Yeah, of course.
So there's a couple bosses that I fought that they just wrecked my ass, and I had no chance.
Right. Okay. All right. I'm gonna pop back in.
All right. Let's do it.
Okay. I can't do it while I'm holding a stick because I want to dodge roll right away. Oh wait, I have another menu. Fuck, I didn't even press the right button to dodge roll, so thank God for that.
You did it.
I fucked up and I stayed alive.
So one of the things that I actually really adore about this game is that you see the currency?
How it floats to you, yeah.
It just, dude, it will chase you.
Which is great.
It wants you.
Made me panic for a little bit, but...
Yeah, because you're like, well, are those enemies?
Yeah.
And so far, it just seems like a really solid game with a really, really, like, that quick start option is...
That's really cool.
...is wonderful. For just like, oh, I just want to play one run.
Oh, bummer.
I just want to do it once.
Just get me in there now.
And
so does it just put you at the character select?
It pops you into the Gungeon with the last
like
character.
Oh, the last character. Nice. That's smart.
Because it assumes that you've probably picked one that you like.
Yeah. So what's this X door up here?
Oh, that's a door that you can open from the other side.
Ah, okay.
So you notice you can push that table?
And you can shoot through it, I bet,
right?
So I'm
going to point it. Yeah, so it blocks bullets for a while.
Okay, cool.
If you see a table, you can hit A and you'll kick it over.
Okay.
And if you see a barrel, you can hit A and you'll roll it.
Right.
And that's the last control. Oh, no, there's one more. If you click both analog sticks, you'll enter a blank. And that removes every bullet from the screen.
Oh, okay.
It's those blue things underneath your health.
Right, I see. So it's like a bomb.
It's like a bomb, but it doesn't do any damage.
Right, okay. That's cool. It's a good feature. So I was going to say, like, already I can see how the quantity of bullets is going to start getting high.
Oh, get that key.
Oh, I see. Okay, yeah. Oh, and they put it on the map so you know.
Wow, this is actually one of the luckiest runs I've ever seen because, keys are quite rare.
Oh, yeah? So getting three of them is...
It's great.
It's almost like I'm really, really good at this game.
It's almost like you're super good at it. You see, he kicked over the little table.
Yeah, I see it. These guys are so cute.
So I was really worried because I played this game for a couple hours and seemed to make no progress because I can't beat the second boss.
Uh-huh.
And I was really worried until I found that in the second level there are characters that you can rescue. And it appears that you can rescue a different one every time as long as you get to that second level.
Right. Oh, shit.
Yeah, this guy's for real. He's like a little mini boss. And the bosses are like full bullet hell pattern.
Yeah, no, for sure.
I would expect no less. Oh, sick! Nice.
I got a gun.
What gun did you get?
I got a witch pistol.
So hit Y to swap between them.
Swap.
And if you hold Y, you will go into slowdown time.
Now, oh, that's a nice reload.
So those have limited ammo.
Yeah, I can see
and
that.
And the ammo is actually limited because ammo pickups are very rare.
Oh, okay. So don't expect to keep using this gun after you've run out.
I've had a couple times where I've used a gun until it's dry and then found another gun and then used it until it's dry.
Oh, is this the boss room?
That's the boss room.
Sick. Yep. It's going to be a good time.
Who are you fighting? Oh, you're fighting these two.
Oh, these two. I saw them in the thing.
It's the Trigger Twins.
Sick.
You can do it. Oh, that thing does a lot of damage. Damn. So these guys are both going to shoot stuff at you, and they're also going to summon in little dudes. And once you kill one, the other will double up.
Yeah, for sure.
so it's not actually easier. It's about the same. Like, I'm not sure if the better method is to, like, keep both alive until the end or whatever. I've only fought them once.
Okay.
I usually end up fighting, the... What's it called? The bird with the Gatling gun.
Yeah, I saw that in your...
Who they are fighting to not call Vulcan Raven.
What was he called?
I forget his name because okay. My brain just auto-completes to Vulcan Raven. Like, when he dies, the ravens come out and eat him.
That's cool.
Like, he's the same. You're doing all right.
I'm actually kind of surprised.
You're doing much better against the boss than you were against the regular enemies. That's really goofy. Yeah, so like I was saying, like, I was getting really worried. So you can rescue those people, and you can also, there's also, like, general progression that seems to take place as you go through more runs. So even though I didn't succeed all that often, those are health items up there.
You still got more stuff.
There was a guy that was like, hey man, beehive. Huh.
Well, I'll try it.
That's a gun, I guess.
Yeah, I guess so. You know what? If you're going to call it a gun, I'll take it.
And it has infinite ammo. It is an infinite clip.
Yeah, so you never have to reload it. Although it looks like the bullets just go in whatever the fuck direction.
Yeah. All right. Now, before you move
Gungeon
forward...
Gungeon proper.
Before you move forward, that thing is eventually going to drop down, I think, if you move out of move away from it. What the fuck, man?
Oh, I see.
Like, because the guy told me to meet him in the level 2. Oh, there it goes. It went down.
Yeah, okay. There
so drop down there.
Oh, you want me to drop down there?
Yeah. Because there's a guy in there who wants to meet me in the Gungeon
level. For your progression. Yeah. I see. Okay. Hey there, I started fixing this thing, but I'm going to need some parts to get it working.
These bullet elevators leave a lot of debris, and I need to clear some out of the way.
To do that, I'll need 3 blanks. Fuck, well...
Well, if you find a 3rd blank...
Try to return here.
Come
okay.
back, and that'll
sure.
be progression.
What's the blank button? No, so I try not to use it.
It's clicking in both sticks.
Okay. Oh my god, fuck this gun.
It actually looks really good.
Yeah, no, they're homing in pretty well, just slowly.
And also, these guys are...
Yeah.
Oh, that's ammo.
I should probably go get it.
Now, it'll only...
Oh, I have to pick it up.
It'll only give you ammo for the gun that you're using.
Ah, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
So you have to often, like, min-max and be like, okay, what do I want? Yeah, so the Gungeon proper is, like, you're fighting a lot of guys with bullet hell patterns instead
of just
firing, like, 1 shot or 2 shots.
No, definitely on the first floor, they were just, but yeah, exactly, pew, 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 nothing.
Every now and then you find a regular bullet guy that has an AK or a shotgun, and those are more for real.
Mm-hmm.
But in general, it's pretty easy. The only real challenge being the boss.
Right.
But down here, like, almost everybody throws out big patterns like that.
I like all the tables. That's super cool.
Yeah, it's really nice.
You mentioned them before, and I wasn't sure how much I was going to use
them. Also, when you fight the bosses, the bosses have the same moves, but occasionally you'll fight them in different rooms.
Oh!
You know, that's the Iron Maiden guy.
Right.
That's another mini-boss. He shoots out 1 million of those, and then they all do that shit!
That's super cool.
Like, I still have not gotten past the 2nd level because I'm very bad at this game.
Right.
I'm very excited to see what's in the 3rd level, but I can't beat the tier 2 bosses.
Oh, is this a shopkeep?
That's a shopkeep.
Sick. I have 106, there's a blank, I should get it.
You can buy a blank.
Okay, I'm gonna bring that back to wherever. What is this? I can't afford it. Heart. I'll take it.
And you can buy that gun over there, probably.
Potion of lead skin.
That's a usable item. I'm not sure what it does. Probably makes you stronger.
I want to keep this gun.
I'm invincible.
So should I use it?
Yeah, you can use it.
Wait, hang on. I want to use this first. What buttons use again? RB?
RB, yeah.
So I want to get ammo first.
There you got it. All right.
And then I guess I'll hang on to that for now. Oh, fuck. My wallet needs to reload. Okay.
So you can teleport back to the elevator.
Oh, right. That's
true. So hold LB.
LB.
Right, and right analog stick. And then you just go all the way back and then hit A on that.
Handy. What's this over here?
That's the elevator room.
I see.
It exists off map for, like, usability
purposes. Right, I follow. That makes sense.
All right, woo! New elevator.
Take it.
Yeah, give it.
Here you go. I'll get to blasting and clear the way, but then I'll need some replacement parts. Can you bring 120 bullets and 3 keys? Maybe?
120.
That's a lot.
Is what you had before.
Yeah, I had that much before. Will this warp me right back then?
Will warp you right back.
Nice. That's really cool, actually.
It's just, I've just found it so easy to just... So I'm playing two games right now in my personal time.
Mm-hmm.
This and Pillars of Eternity.
Can I roll these gaps?
Yes, or? In fact, you have to.
Yeah, okay.
This and Pillars of Eternity. They could not
Very
be
similar.
More opposite in time and investment.
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm just like, I just want to play something, I'm throwing this in.
Mm-hmm.
And when I'm like, I want to sit down for three
Forever
hours.
Forever and ever. Oh no, what
and
are you?
And have an adventure.
Oh shit.
Yep. Yep, it's that.
Piece cake.
You did it.
These bees are great.
These bees are great?
What the fuck was the change weapon thing again? Why? Oh no, I used my item. Why'd I do it? Because I was trying to remember how to change the fucking...
It's Y to change your weapon.
It's Y to change my weapon. Okay, there we go. All right, time for the boss.
Oh, you're going for it? Oh, shit, it's the Gorgon.
It's going to be a piece of cake.
Sorry, it's the Gorgon.
Oh. It's almost like you did that on purpose.
They're all like that. There's a beholder that just holds a gun in every single one of its tentacles.
Oh, yeah, that's the one they use in all their promo art.
And it's
yeah.
the beholster.
Nice. Oh, it's poison.
Yeah, it's poison. Sick. This is actually a really good weapon.
This is a really good gun.
You're going to run out of ammo at some point,
yeah.
but it's still a really good gun for this. Wow, you're actually going to beat the fucking second boss on your first try, and I can't... Oh.
I feel really good about this.
The witch pistol might serve you a little better.
Yeah.
Yeah. I hate you, Liam. Why are you so young and good at video games? Why you like this? Yeah, those bullet hell patterns are... Like, we've already seen, like, a really massive upgrade from boss 1 to boss 2.
Yeah. Oh, fuck.
It makes me worry as to, like... I don't know how many floors the Gungeon has. And it really...
But it's
really,
gonna get pretty intense.
Yeah. Like, I expect that the final boss is, like, full-on Toho.
It's just Cerno with a gun.
I actually really like that... You have a big hitbox in this game.
Yeah.
But bullets are also quite large, and the spaces in between them are also very large.
Yeah, I fucking did it. I'm enjoying this game. I'm having a really fun time.
Yeah, so you played Nuclear Throne, right?
I played Nuclear Throne a lot.
Okay, so you were telling me...
Oh, no.
You were telling me, I really want to know which is better, this or Nuclear Throne. So now you have the ability to somewhat... Answer the question.
Yeah, so Nuclear Throne's sick. Nuclear Throne's great, and it's super goofy, and all the characters are, like, way more varied than the characters in this.
Yeah, that's the only big problem I have, is that the difference between the characters, I'm disappointed that they're not more wild and variability.
Should I jump down here, too?
Yeah, why not?
This...
So he's not down here, because he's in level 2-1.
Right,
one.
He still has to do... Oh, fuck. Spawn me a
pit. I found that thing by accident, because usually you get hurt if you fall down pits.
Yeah, of course.
And I accidentally went in there. That's a good one. Now, here's the deal. Weapon power is pretty much correlated with how much ammo you get with it.
That makes sense.
So this
You're
thing
gonna
is...
Get a, this doesn't have a ton of bullets.
This thing is great.
Yeah.
But it's...
But it's gonna run out.
Ammo.
Yeah.
So yeah, Nuclear Throne.
I think this one's more...
Holy shit!
I think this game is more like... instantly fun than Nuclear Throne.
What's the gameplay in Throne?
It's pretty much the same, but you have to put a lot more work in to feel as satisfied.
Okay, where's
this game has a lot more just goofy quality and feels fun.
Well,
it feels fun to do anything in this game.
The
weapons are more interesting.
The thing that resonates with me here is that, like, the default pistol feels good to shoot guys.
Yeah,
with.
Definitely. In Nuclear Throne, the weapons are generally a lot more bland. Not all across the board, but...
So what's Nuclear Throne's big gimmick?
The different characters, definitely, okay. Yeah.
So if I'm having fun with this, should I check out Nuclear Throne?
I think you'd enjoy it, absolutely,
okay.
Absolutely. I'd be hard-pressed to say which one's better.
Oh, don't miss
that's
that,
crazy.
That health,
oh,
by the way.
Yeah, I always forget to press
if
A.
If you leave the health in a room for any length of time, mm-hmm. There's a thief that lives down here that can come take it.
Okay, but you can kill him.
Yeah, no, because you'll just find a note that says, thanks for the ammo, sucker.
Oh.
Oh, man. Man, I'm so glad I got to see this level. Stop. Oh.
Well, you'll take the controller next, and you'll show us all level 4.
No, I don't think that's going to happen.
We'll see.
Because you're actually doing, like, way better than I thought you would. You know what I love?
I'm doing better than I thought I would.
I love how you just walk through everything, and it
yeah.
explodes.
No, it's cool. I agree. And that's what I mean by, like, good feel. Everything
Oh,
that's cool. Everything just feels satisfying in this game instantly.
Yeah, like, without the roguelike elements,
oh,
this would also be a good shooter.
Yeah, definitely.
You know what? It's goofy because I've mentioned it in the past, but no one knows what I'm talking about because it's like this ancient PC game from like 92 that only came on demo discs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a game called Cyber Dogs. And this is a...
Yeah, you've talked about it before, but this, I don't know anything about that game.
This game is like a really, really good version of Cyber Dogs.
Okay. And so that's good because it's bringing you back to your past.
Yeah, it's shocking how similar it is.
Oh, this place looks dangerous.
Oh, get on that shit.
Can I go through these things? Yeah.
You can go through it. Oh!
You can probably jump them in tons of sick ways.
You can hit LB, yeah. LT when you're in there. Oh!
So you just hop out of them, basically.
Yeah, so... Oh, I see what you have to do.
But yeah, but that can't go anywhere. It's in the spikes.
Yeah, it's in the spikes, but you can do it to the other one.
Fuck.
To the right, I think. No?
That seems pretty far.
No way.
Let's see. A just gets out.
Huh.
B is the roll as well.
Yeah.
Y is change weapon. I don't know.
Give it a shot. The worst thing that'll happen is you'll take one pip of damage.
No, because then I'm going to die and this perfect run's going to end.
Okay, you're right. Hey, everyone. Liam beat the game.
Dude, if I could actually beat the game, it'd fucking blow my mind. It's not going to happen, but...
That, Yeah, you're good at this because you played a bunch
of nuclear throw. Yeah, for sure. Without that, I'd probably be long
like
dead.
Like, this is the first time I've ever played anything to any degree that was bullet heli.
Right.
Aside from, like very casually and shittily playing Ikaruga.
Right.
Those are just the bubble bobble guys!
Yeah, pretty much, actually.
There's a lot of referential stuff in here. I was talking to somebody, and it's like, I am thrilled in this new era in that... I love to play big games that last me forever. I put 156 hours in a Witcher 3, and I'm gonna go back for the DLC, probably put 40 more in, right?
But it's nice that there's all this
but
shit all over the
in
place.
Between,
yeah,
there is just this endless plethora of indie games to just...
That are quality, too.
That are good. They're not just, like, time wasters. I just happen to be wasting my time with them.
Yeah. No, I totally agree. And, like, well, and there's, like, genuine depth and
there's stuff
to do.
I'm glad to see people picking up where Rogue Legacy left off.
Yeah.
And because I had a feeling when I was playing Rogue Legacy, it's like, man, this is going to be, like, an all-time great classic.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing's ever going to come close to this.
And it was really fucking good.
And, like, no shade to throw on Rogue Legacy, but, like, a ton of games of that similar type
of
have come
that caliber,
out that
yeah.
have come out, and they're also really good. This happens to be one of them. I know Matt's playing it. He's liking it a lot.
Yeah, he was telling me he was really enjoying it.
Nuclear Throne is apparently, I've been hearing a lot about
Nuclear Throne's really good.
And there's probably a couple others that we're forgetting.
Oh, without a doubt, Binding of Isaac.
Yeah. You know what I really like about this game compared to Binding of Isaac, and mm-hmm. it has something to do with what you were saying about Nuclear Throne? I think that when you start Binding of Isaac, your character sucks.
It takes a long time for the fun to sink in.
I think the first 10 minutes of Binding of Isaac are genuinely terrible.
They're kind
of
miserable.
And
maybe that's the point.
You play that first 10 minutes a lot.
Yeah.
And I really wanted...
Oh, shit.
I really, really wanted to like Binding of Isaac, but that just, like...
Yeah, no, I agree. What's
because I'm not good at these games.
A cell key. Oh, is that to get a person?
Yeah, there's a review on Rock, Paper, Shotgun of a guy, I forget his name, but in which he describes, like, I am terrible at Enter the Gungeon.
Right.
But I'm still having fun with it. Ooh. Because you're allowed to have fun with it if you're terrible.
It's really easy to
unlike
enjoy
some
this
of
game.
The other ones. Mm-hmm. Like, if I'm bad at this, would you say Nuclear Throne is, like, too hard or what?
Nuclear Throne's harder.
Man, I just realized that you're turning guys into chickens.
Yeah, I noticed that too. I think that's the witch gun.
Yeah. If you have a tough time, remember, you can hit RB to become temporarily invincible.
Yeah.
That's a really good one. I have gotten, like, really, really bad ones. Oh, look at that big mushroom. I've never seen that guy before.
You know what? I'm gonna use Beehive. Just empty this shit out.
Yeah.
Let's just get rid of all that.
Well, this is a good problem room to use the Beehive on.
Yeah, for sure.
You got the big arm and the Marines. Yeah. So you can just hold that if you want. Yeah, okay.
No, exactly. I don't want to waste it if I don't
have it. They block shots.
That's sick.
That's really interesting.
So they're actually, like, super useful.
So I... Oh, well, the t-shirt...
Oh, my God.
You were looking at before.
Did you see that? These, like, glowing ones come towards you after?
The t-shirt one?
Yeah, yeah,
that doesn't do that much damage, but it has tons of knockbacks on its stages that have lots of pits. It's quite useful.
Mm-hmm.
And there's another one that I found that was a barrel of fish that did okay damage, but it had a chance to stun and dizzy guys if it hit them.
That's really cool.
So I hit the boss, and I it didn't work on the boss.
You know what else is really fucking cool? That enemy just shot at a barrel I was standing near.
Yep. Yo! Like,
explicitly. Oh, good. This is what
Yo!
I
Yo!
Hexagun.
Light fantastic.
Great.
Don't even shoot that until you find something good. Oh, there's unlockable doors! Oh, yeah!
Yeah, I found a jellyfish.
Talk to him! Whoa!
That ain't English. Someone decipher this for me.
It's like a Mr. What's his name?
Mr. Saturn.
Mr. Saturn.
So is he gonna, like, leave the Gungeon of his own accord?
He is now available.
Right, cool, okay.
So yeah, LB, and you can instantly go back to some location that you want to go to.
This one looks good.
I love the teleport feature in this game.
It's really handy, and I like how it keeps a little warp for you to go back. Like, that's really well thought out.
That's a big gun for a little dude.
I hope it shoots good.
That's a rail gun.
Oh, one shot.
I bet it kills. Yep, it's strong.
Oh, fuck.
And I bet it goes through anything it hits.
What's the burst button again? Like, to use the bomb?
The blanks?
Yeah.
It's both click and both sticks.
Both sticks, right, okay. Sorry, like three times. I don't want to forget when it comes down to
it. They made it so that you're not going to do that shit by accident.
Right, okay. So this is an item. Or what is that?
No,
it's an option.
Okay, hit select, and you can mouse over it, and it'll tell you what it does. Attacks
enemies.
The orange guanstone boosted the bear's damage, but the belligerite
stone
at the core...
itself. The belligerite.
Wow.
Great. Great.
So, it's just going to attack people?
I guess so.
So, I've been playing the game for a couple hours, mm-hmm. and I have yet to see a single repeat anything. Like
items, you're still going through unique ones all the time?
Not only is there a ton of them, mm-hmm. but they seem to have some kind of system in the game in that, like, you're more likely to see ones
to
you
see
haven't
new ones,
seen.
Yeah.
Well, shit! Here we go.
I don't know about this one. This one's gonna be dodgy, but...
Yo.
Where's the gun?
Cannon Balrog. Oh, hey! That doesn't seem to be doing that much damage.
Well.
Oh, fuck. Oh!
There we go. That's cool.
And then you get shot with the gun that kills the past.
Right.
And then...
And it erases what
then you
did.
Return to the breach. Don't show the mouse cursor.
Why was the mouse there?
So grab the marine. And I just want to explore this place. Hand that off to me.
Here you go.
All right. So I just want to show off the breach. So when I started the game, this area was completely empty.
Like there was no items.
There were
and tents
there was
shit?
No tents. There was nothing. Every time I run, there appears to be one new thing
that just appears.
That was added because
that's really cool.
Because these guys are making a living down here.
Just as time passes.
I actually and again.
Can you leave?
You can totally. I'll show you. So that's the elevator guy. I can talk to him, and then you can skip to the to certain floors once
I
you unlock
see.
That.
So if I would have been able to fill out all the items he needed, you'd be able to jump.
I bet the first one is saved, and I only need to do the second.
Yeah, I think so too.
This is these people I saved.
Ah, I see.
I'm
uncertain as to my purpose here.
So what they do is that you see that currency in the upper right.
Oh, and they unlock them in the dungeon.
They unlock them in the dungeon.
Right.
So if I talk to this, the RPG will now show up.
Cool. That's awesome. That's like in Crypt of the Necrodancer. They have the same thing.
And she said something about, like, if you get all of them, just leave and come back.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's pretty much it for my base right now. I bet the little guy that you rescued is going to show up in the
somewhere.
Shop.
Yeah.
There's a different bullet guy that I rescued that just shows up as an extra merchant sometimes.
Okay.
So... I guess we're gonna leave the Gungeon, and it's my favorite thing when I went to the bottom and realized what happens.
Yeah, I want
to
see this.
When you walk out the door.
I feel like I have a good idea. Yeah.
Like, awesome. Isn't that great?
That's great.
That you walk out the door and
then
you're out
the
door.
Screen. Exactly.
Great.
That's great.
I'm gonna be wasted. I'm gonna check on Nuclear Throne also.
You should.
But yeah, this game's
good
a lot
video
of fun.
Game.
Wait a second.
What?
Some new warriors have joined the tournament.
Oh, Texas man appears.
Oh, shit.
It's Austin Eruption.
Hello.
We have some thoughts about the Gungeon, too.
We do.
But Austin is here, and he's just like, oh, you guys played Enter the Gungeon, right? How much you played? And I was like, I don't know, like 5 to 30 minutes. And he's like, I played it like a year ago. And Austin's like, I've spent 5,000 hours.
5,000 hours of my whole life. Actually went into the hyperbolic time chamber to play this game specifically.
There you go.
So let's fucking do it.
Let's enter it.
Yeah, so, like, Austin is a guarantee this will be a no-death run, which is always great.
Yeah, yep. Guaranteed.
That Audacity timer is also a speedrun timer.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
shit.
We're going to be marking this according to the rules of
AGDQ. He's pretty good already.
Yeah. I've told you, man, I've been playing it a bunch.
Yeah, I know you have.
So, yeah, this game was, like, love at first sight. The moment I touched it. It was like, okay, flip the tables up, learn how to roll works, perfect.
I didn't even see the game first. I heard the name, and I was like, that's a good
it's
name.
It's a good damn
it
name.
It is a strong-ass name.
Exactly.
I've been waiting for this for what feels like 2 years, at the very minimum.
Because it's been a while where, like, when we went to PAX East 2015, I played a little bit, too, and I was like, wow, this is great. And then if you guys saw the really cool title art for this video, one of the artists at Dodgeball Games was like, I'm a big fan of Best Friends.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe we can make some title art for you guys whenever you do a video.
Yeah.
I was like, cool, yeah, I know, absolutely.
And
when's the game coming out? Oh, the third quarter of 2015, and that rolled around, and I was like, grrrr,
yeah.
So I'm glad it's out now.
So that's the guy that walked me through it, and like I just sat
exactly.
at that booth and went fucking through because it was so good. So this and Nuclear Throne, and
mm-hmm.
you're done.
Mm-hmm.
Those are your twin-stick shooters.
You don't need
on Steam, and you're done.
Yeah.
And that was what Liam and I were overwhelmingly left with as an impression of PAX, was that this year's especially, was that you walk through the indie booth and stuff, and there's a lot of games that look like Enter the Gungeon or Nuclear Throne-esque.
Yeah. The year of the
shooters that were twins.
And they don't look like bad games, they look like all right, but these
Ooh.
Two, and this game in specific, is so good that you don't need that space to be covered anymore.
Yeah, yeah, it's been thoroughly gungeoned already.
Handled, explored.
It's been thoroughly featuring sticks
now
of the twin variety.
Now, when I did play the original build, it only had this main character. So do tell, Mr. Austin. Austin of Austin. What are the other characters about?
So you have the convict, who's kind of like a prisoner.
I like her.
Yeah, she's pretty rad. She has one of her advantages is that she has a sawed-off shotgun, as well as her normal gun.
Okay.
The pilot here actually has this first starting weapon, this little laser gun, and also, if you look at the bottom left, you'll see a little, like, key thing. And he gets a chance to open every chest without, like, consuming
a
key.
He has, like, a lockpick.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And, but if it fails, then you can't open that chest even with a key. So it's like a risk versus reward type thing.
Got it. Interesting.
I hate the risk part of risk and reward.
Can't you just win?
Why can't you just win all the time?
There's also the, we'll use it real quick. It's right bumper, I think. What is it? Right, left shirt. Okay, there we
you
go.
You got it.
You Yay. Got the super soaker.
Glacier.
You got the Vita gun.
Oh my god.
Glacier, Woolie's favorite WCW character.
He does the cryonic kick.
Yeah, and he looks like Sub-Zero. He's probably dead now, though.
That's the boss chamber. We don't want to
go there yet. Oh,
wrong button. So the,
gotta love those menus, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There's also...
it reminds you of Bayonetta.
Anything that's a tome gets bonus points.
Now, there's also the hunter who has the corgi.
Oh, right. Yeah, no, that's fine.
Oh,
that's fine.
And, like, you get, like, a buddy dog?
Yeah, and the corgi will, search out treasure. So if you, like, finish a room, he'll dig around and, like, try to find some stuff for you.
Cool.
I had heard about it, but I didn't know what he did.
It's not a battle corgi, though.
Corgi in there. Battle corgi!
Is it?
Love it.
It's the best.
Okay.
And, here we go.
Shoddy. It's just a regular shotgun.
Right, it's just regular, yeah.
Don't worry about it. Like, it's just a regular shotgun. That's all he needs to be.
Sometimes it's just a shotgun.
I get a little OCD about these rooms sometimes, and I have to run over every pot and flip every table over.
Well, no, it makes sense.
It's like, no.
You're at my place earlier today. You're flipping over all my shit, like, looking for treasure.
I'm trying to remember.
Damn it, Texas man.
There we go.
Gotta turn off the light switch 5 times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Thankfully, this game allows you to, like, travel real fast, though, with the teleport system.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, there's 2 rooms over here. Boom. Let's go.
And it's like, as long as you touch the teleporter, you can, like, use it, right?
Yeah. Well, they know what this is like 80 hours in.
Yeah. You know,
so...
Don't waste my time.
That's what more games need to account for.
Mm-hmm.
And I love how the regular enemies are just bullet men.
No, that's all they need.
I love the way their gun turns, man. So fucking good.
They're entering the Gungeon, and they're like, well, I'm gonna have to be ready. My gun has to turn to... Oh,
yeah. Extra heart. Yeah.
So lucky so far.
Yeah, also. It's like, this is a good run already.
I love how you wear your heart on your sleeve.
Yeah.
Dude, your hearts are made of bullets.
And your bullets are made of hearts. That's the other thing that I've seen.
No, like, literally in the top corner. They are made of bullets.
The two bullets overlaid on top of each other, yeah. Is that, like, this? I've seen a lot of people just... loving, like, the kind of cute little writing for this game. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, a lot of little... Not like, cringeworthy stuff. Just, you know, kind of clever, fun little things.
And it's not memes.
Yeah, it's not dark memes.
Also, like, the running animations, of course, being super bouncy and fun. Specifically, the way he runs upwards, like, when his back is facing the camera, the little jaunt from left to right is super cute.
Mm-hmm. And his hair wiggles around. It reminds me of Maguma and his little, like, fucking, sort of mohawk thing and just kind of bounces around.
So your OCD thing is flipping up tables. My OCD thing is running and making the character face the correct direction.
Oh yeah?
Yes. But
as you're shooting?
No, not in battle.
Okay.
But like if he's running upwards towards like another teleporter.
How can you run like that, sir?
Every room just has to be thoroughly destroyed. That's what I need.
That's all he needs.
Because gun ghost.
Good job.
The big aesthetic of my life is the Matrix fight scene in the lobby.
Oh.
Every room I leave, it's gotta look like that.
It's gotta look like that.
So watch out, man.
People got married in that lobby.
Yeah.
That's what they like.
As you should.
As it's the only way you
bullet should. Holes and all.
Yeah, exactly.
And
oh!
He just wants to spell things.
Books. He just wants to learn.
What's your problem?
The boss of this level is LeVar Burton. Big giant library.
Right, so here's our shop.
Yeah,
what nice. I love is if you shoot in here, he gets all mad.
Hey, no fire.
As you fucking should.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
So I'm gonna... Let's see what we got.
What's that over there?
Or this?
Yeah.
It's just a crossbow. It's all right.
It's not great. The prices should go down.
Just because...
All prices are double!
He's mad now.
Yeah, and his eyes are red.
Look at that.
And
that would be almost like...
You're done. you're just
nice,
done.
You don't buy things anymore. Actually, he closes the shop permanently.
Super butthurt that you started like just throwing the lead around.
Did you ruin my playthrough forever?
No. Just this run.
Okay.
Because yeah, this
I ruined your entire file.
It's like Undertale. It commits to your fucking desktop.
This is kind of procedural. Like it's kind of randomly generated. How the dungeons are stitched together.
Yeah, it's all random. And I have the console version, and it takes a minute to load that.
Okay.
Like I said, procedural generation is also running its course right now in the industry, but
kids like it.
But this is good so far.
Are you guys ready for this though?
Not yet.
Vulcan Raven?
Not this. The little splash. It's so good.
Yeah.
Gatling Go is just as good as Vulcan Raven.
Just as strong, if not stronger.
Yeah. That's a very Broforce type of boss.
Oh,
but it's,
totally.
But it's just they know to do a better Metal Gear. Basically.
Yeah, exactly.
This is what Kojima really would have done.
Yeah, no.
If he had no limits.
He could have like a feathery going on.
Right.
He would have.
If the Konami wasn't holding Kojima back.
Well, see, this is what like Kojima is apparently a huge fan of Zootopia, and with his new studio opening up.
Right.
You know, he's making that Zootopia game. Right?
Yeah.
That's true. I heard about that.
The Zootopia first-person shooter.
Finally, Kojima's obsession with animals can reach its full state.
Yeah, exactly. You see Zootopia.
Solid Snake was always meant to be a real snake, you guys.
Solid Snake, why don't you just call him a hard dick?
This guy is easy peasy.
What do you get?
Shield of the Maiden.
Yeah, let's see what we get up here. Oh, look at, they're gonna consume him.
Yeah, as they do, man.
The murder of crows.
Back to
we
your
We never
origins.
Even got to pull each other's ears.
And they're gone. All right, so...
That's the harsh rule of being in the murder of crows. They all eat you.
Down with that.
It's a pretty decent gun.
See, I've played this a bunch, and I haven't seen this gun before, or the Glacier gun.
Cool.
There's so many guns in this game.
I mean, it makes sense, right?
It is a Gungeon, after all.
These remind me of, like, Skullgirls.
The loading screen. I was like, is he gonna make it? Is he gonna make it? No,
he's too fat. Gun can never fit in there. Like, the very idea that a dodge roll can get you across shit is
it's
like,
also a
insane.
Jump. Yeah.
It's also a jump and
solid.
That's what I do in real life.
So it's fine. Like that's like Devil May Cry's team within Capcom just being called the Rebellion team.
Right.
Or like the Cerebus team or whatever.
Why is it that the best run I've had of this game so far is not at home on my own console?
But recorded live on someone else's.
Yeah. You're confident now.
It's true.
Everyone can see it.
Yeah, everyone can see your confidence.
No one will ever doubt you again.
The bristling confidence of your pubic hair.
Five of my pubic hair. It's true.
I'm sure there's a gun like that in this game anyway.
Oh, there we go.
There you go, yeah.
It was just a shield, though. It's fine.
No, but it's like you finally took a hit.
No, I woke up this morning and Matt's just trying to, like, pull my blanket off me. And
I was like, get up! Time to work!
I'm like, I don't want to wake up!
Well, those guys look really cute, though. I feel bad for those ones.
They have to be murdered!
I guess. They have to be punished.
So, Texasman, what do you think of Montreal so far?
Montreal's pretty alright. I like it. It's not boiling hot outside, and that's what really matters to me.
And it's not, like, painful cold where you're losing life.
It's true.
Well, he's here at the time where it's not painful cold where it'll make him lose life. He's lucky.
I'm not taking damage.
Yeah, no.
Time.
Frendrana Drifts has been closed temporarily for the season.
Yeah. it might show up at any given time.
Just listen out for that Storm Eagle guitar riff, and then he'll eventually drop in and start doing the gusts of wind at you.
Though, Void Car. Anymore because he's like, that
he
guy tried to shoot
all
me.
Up. Close it all
Can you read the notes?
Let's see. No, they're just like little, like, crossed out,
out
circles.
Out of business.
They say, fuck you, Austin.
Someone ruined it for everyone.
It was me.
That's fine.
Yeah, this is a key door. I've not actually seen a key door before.
You have a key, though.
Oh, did you see him?
Yeah. He's like, no. You've played hours of this and you've never gone into a certain type of door?
That's random.
This
game is amazing.
Game. It's ridiculous.
Like, anytime someone who's like a at least 20-hour veteran of a game goes, what is that?
Yeah.
I can't believe
it. There are so many things I just haven't seen before in this run already. Like, this bullshit.
Imagine you're on, like, hour 90 of Okami, and you go, what is that?
What?
It's almost like playing,
There's resource gathering!
Mario and Luigi games, where you have tutorials, like, 30 hours in, so...
Oh, the Superstar Saga.
Yeah. It's like, oh, no.
Oh, jeez. What? All if right. you play Okami past the 100-hour mark, there's microtransactions?
So I failed this lockpick.
Oh. Yep.
I can't open it ever. But forever. I can't shoot it. And I got... Junk.
Next time, use a key.
Fuck
asshole.
Fuck you.
I know.
Texas man.
It's punishing me.
Yeah, no, with no your shit. Luck, that would have been a mimic. The only mimic in the game.
Oh, shit.
There are mimics.
Oh, there really is?
Yeah. And that's one of the perks of having the Hunter's Corgi, because the Corgi will actually just bark at mimics to let you know.
Nice.
But mimics have good loot once you beat them.
Okay, so it's like, you know, balanced or whatever.
Yeah.
That was just a cube guy.
Yeah, but he was angry and bad.
I guess.
You should be able to summon a battle corgi in Dark Souls.
Now, if we recall, the story of this game is that if you can get a gun that can kill time, that's the ultimate goal, right?
I want that gun.
Kill the guy that stole your Hulk doll, kill your family that busted up your Hulk doll, or kill the guy that stole your Game Boy.
You just stand where you are and shoot into... Like, anything. Shoot forward, and you just think about where you want it to go, and the bullet goes there.
Yeah. Fuck you, Bless.
So, like, you just fire into midair, and then I kill that guy that stole my thing, and then suddenly I feel better.
Yeah.
You just feel better by shooting into...
wave.
Of, you know...
Of, like, super happiness.
See, when I think of a gun that can kill time, I just think of like Pornhub or something.
That technically does kill all time.
Yeah, right? Kill time. Right.
I got that Star Wars thing. That thing's good.
All right, what do we got? The Gungeon, it's too big. Wow, okay, I'm already here. Teleport
there
to it.
There you go, awesome. That saved a lot of time.
It did. Oh. We're gonna mess this guy. Oh, this boss.
Void Core.
That looks like it's from Snake Rattle and Roll.
It looks like that.
Ammo Conda.
Yeah. Or anytime I see something made of circles, I think of treasure.
Or like Zelda.
Oh yeah, totally.
Overhead Zeldas.
Right.
This is giving me like Gunstar. Or
Gunstar.
Alien Soldier.
Alien
vibes.
Soldier. Yeah, all yeah, absolutely. Treasure are the masters of making up bosses out of circles.
Treasure are the masters of balls.
Slow down.
Shit, nice.
So you see there's like little blue ammo shells underneath my health.
Uh-huh.
Those are blanks. They actually refill every floor, but what they do is this. They clear all the bullets out.
Yeah.
Wow.
And they're consumable.
That is awesome. God, there's a shmup that has a bomb like that. There's a Japanese shmup that where like your bomb doesn't kill the enemies, it just clears the bullets off screen.
Seems like it'd be useful.
Super good.
Ah, god.
And blanks are pretty rare though, eh?
Yeah. Well, no, they refill every floor.
But you get how
and
many?
You can buy them. And the thing about having the corgi is that it'll find like little hearts and things in the floor.
Them.
Yeah.
Oh, that should happen.
But we got the gold key. There's something on this floor then that we gotta find then. All right, what do we get?
I've got Jolter.
Messed around. I keep thinking about that shopkeeper and like, what if you fought him?
You can actually kill him. It is very, very hard.
But it's doable.
It is doable.
But then you become the shopkeeper.
Yeah. For the rest of your playthrough, you have to sit there and wait
for other Gungeoners to come in.
So you see this gun right here? Big bullets.
Nice.
Gonna They're miss bigger than you!
I know, it's great!
They're slightly bigger than you.
I've seen the final boss of this game once, and just wait. There's some big guns there.
Okay.
Oof. Oof.
Like Cable-style big guns?
Bigger.
Oh, man.
Cable doesn't have shit on this boy.
Oh, boy.
I don't know. Cable's got pretty badly drawn giant guns. Yeah.
Look at all the guns we have. This is amazing. What is this?
It bounce gun.
I'll take it.
Yep.
It
never quits.
Okay, so we don't have a key, so I can't go into the secret areas. So we'll just go to the next floor.
It actually quits after two bounces, Matt.
Oh.
Does it?
Why do I?
Oh,
no,
that was like four.
No, that was, yeah, all right.
Let's see.
All right, that was quite
like
a bit.
Five. Yeah, that was like five or six.
All right, he's good for a night. He's got some good stamina.
Well, those are like the kind of fucking things that drill up from the Technodrome, but they're just giant bullets.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Black Powder Mine seems like the worst place to be with a gun. What?
Yeah. Secrets.
Secrets.
You can't do this yet.
That's like a soul secret because it's elevator based.
Mm-hmm. So basically, you find prisoners of the Gungeon in here.
Okay.
And there's a guy that will fix the elevator floor so you can start on the third floor in future playthroughs.
Mm.
And that's where that boy's at.
Okay, that makes sense.
When
pro tips from Arcadia.
Yeah.
Okay, I gotta.
Oh,
that cool dude.
Oh, he moves so cool. How can you be so cool but so cute at the same time?
Oh, Liam Bennett.
That's what my mom says.
About
she would
me.
Know.
About Matt, yeah. Alright, that's not a good gun for this situation.
Yeah, maybe not. I'm not sure, like, pushing tables can, like, just, like, circumvent fire, like, spirit, but I guess it did.
Good job killing Pat there, by the way.
Yeah. And you're red.
It was in my destiny.
What? You separated more bats? That's even more bats.
I mean, look, you're already...
Oh, that's fun.
You're here in Montreal. Now you just have to finish the job and take his place.
Yeah.
And take his place?
And this mic will be dedicated to you.
I am using the Pat mic right now.
And then you have to fight Liam a little bit.
You have to fight Liam a little bit, but then you get to take his house and his girlfriend.
Yeah.
And then we're good.
Oh.
He's already agreed. The terms.
Take from him everything.
How about
give him nothing?
How about the only terms he agrees to is actually following me back on Twitter?
Oh,
fucking shots fired from within the Gungeon.
Oh shit.
God damn.
That's terrible.
The blow up is real. And apparently he wants to hang out with you tomorrow.
Yeah, I know, right?
I don't know. Maybe, you know what?
Pay
maybe
the toll first.
Maybe you should tell him where you're going to hang out on Twitter. Just make a tweet, not at like, anyone.
I'll
just
try to DM you, but you know.
No, not even DM. Just go, hey, just write generally, hey, Pat, so tomorrow let's meet up here and see if he catches it. And if he didn't, oh, guess what? Whose fault is that, fucker?
Certainly not mine.
Balls wrecked.
It's really bad. It's really hot right now. The room is heated.
It's never been more real.
It's never been more real.
I'm getting flustered now. I'm angry thinking about it.
Oh, man, you're half health.
One button. All you have to do.
One button.
It's a giant button, too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you just go offline. I've never seen that enemy before.
Shut
like,
up.
No, I haven't.
Oh my god, at those unflipped tables.
Oh, man. Sorry, hold on.
There we go.
Okay, this is your way.
We're good.
Room clear.
There
save
you go.
The dime. Probably shouldn't have killed the shopkeeper, considering I have so much money.
It was a neat thing, though, to see. Never regret neat things.
I don't regret much.
Even if they fuck you over. Those bullets, like, yeah, that's too much.
This is unfair.
Because their bullets are so smart. Why do they just throw themselves at you if they're bullet men?
Because they don't. They're not
from the Bullet Club.
They're not sentient, Matt.
But they look pretty.
They look like they have a brain.
They look like they would.
But there's no hammer to fire them at.
Yeah,
you.
That's true.
You know,
is a bullet really a bullet if it can never be fired?
Like it's got its shell casing and everything, but it has no purpose in life.
Yeah.
The loneliest bullet.
Loneliest bullet you've ever seen.
He's like, I don't have a gun.
Poor bullet, Chad.
Man. I've never, like, this game's procedurally generated, right? I'm pretty sure they patched in a couple levels since I last played, but...
Maybe.
But, like, I've never seen this room or, like, this turret or anything like that.
Like, setup.
Maybe these are PC exclusive.
Like, they could make it, like, a patch that's just, like, we've included a new asset.
Yeah.
One new asset is part of the mix now.
And it
now.
Changes the whole meta, man.
Yeah.
Everything changes.
We've added swords. It's now called Enter the Swordgeon.
Swordgeon.
Oh, shit, that should be the sequel. Enter the Swordgeon?
So that guy with the green circle I just killed?
Yeah.
That's a buff boy.
So you got a little buff?
So, no, he buffs enemies.
Buff boy.
Oh, right, okay.
Oh, that one just explodes. Man, this controller's super good, though.
It's amazing. The Elite is fantastic.
I'm used to playing this on a PS4 controller, which isn't great. Crossbow?
Pressing crossbow.
Nice. Oh, nice.
That's some Sailor Moon shit.
Little known fact about Buff Bagwell is that he'd buff other wrestlers. That he was on his tag team.
Little known fucking truth about Buff Bagwell, he's a stripper now.
Oh, it charges too.
Oh.
This is the best gun.
This is so pretty. Yeah, seriously. Or Moon Scepter Elimination.
Yeah, Moon Scepter Elimination.
Ah!
You do.
That was an easy corner. You're good.
Oof. Now let's use this.
Oh, man.
It's so good. And, like,
makes it super crazy, though.
Oh, did you see that one hit him after all that time?
A little bit, yeah.
That was great.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay,
perfect. Sweating.
This run is still going fantastic, though.
I know.
Yeah.
I want to. How do the other guys do? Do we know?
Liam did pretty well. Liam did pretty well.
We can take an assumption that it was garbage. Because they weren't following you on Twitter.
It's true. It's true.
Liam did okay. That's all I know.
I'll see if I can get to like the fifth floor. That's my mission.
Mushroom Man.
Yeah, you killed one kind of off screen a little bit before, but. You can see that one in all of its penis-like glory.
So mad that the Mushroom Men sequel never happened.
Well, there were kind of two of them.
But the 2016 remake of Mushroom Men.
Yeah.
This has so much ammo, man!
It has a lot of ammo.
See, like, franchises that need a soft reboot.
Not a hard one.
Soft reboot.
Destroy soft all humans. Mushroom Men.
Under the skin.
Oh. Hey.
Auto Modelestista.
I remember that. But that was like.
No one remembers that.
I remember Auto Modelestista. That was cel shaded, right?
Yeah.
Ninja Bread Man.
Yeah.
Soft reboot.
Anubis 2.
He's spitting at me.
He hates it.
Get out of here.
No way, Texas Man. I will not accept your gift.
When did I become Texas Man? That's what I gotta know.
Guess what?
When
now.
The day you were born and given the name of an Austin fucking. Austin.
We're gonna make a gun.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay, we're going to combine the shotgun with this assault rifle.
Combine a shotgun with a shotgun.
See what you do. What are you going to make for me? What?
It's like a Gatling gun.
Is it a Gatling gun?
The Stinger!
It's drone warfare. Hold on, let's test it.
Is it like a Metal Gear Stinger? Can you control it?
Maybe.
I will fire it and see if I can have...
Because that's what a Stinger usually
is. It fires bees!
Oh, Stinger! I get it.
I don't get it.
Let's test it.
What's happening?
The bees are homing!
The bees track.
They're homing bees! You can't ask for anything better than that.
The only thing better is that the gun was actually just a dog and it shot bees out as well.
The bees are holding swords.
Yeah. The bees have guns.
That fire swords.
That fire swords, exactly.
That's...
Oh, shit.
It's a lot of layers.
Are there any guns that, like, give you, like, options as in, like they float around you?
Yeah, actually. And, like, I'm So there's actually, like, power-up items, too. Like, passive items and stuff.
Right.
We haven't found any this run yet, which is interesting.
Huh.
But there's, like... if I go to the Ammonomicon right here.
Ammonomicon.
So we have active items and passive items.
Right.
And some of them are like we got an extra heart container. But some of them do some crazy stuff. Let's see
okay.
if... I doubt he's back. Okay.
No, he's still butthurt.
No, he's upset.
He really doesn't like it.
I just wanted to sell him some ammo.
Oh, he's so good.
And then he tried to kill me.
I was trying to do right by my wife.
So this is a secret room that... I think it's pretty easy to figure out, but, you know.
Okay, okay.
Ah. Yeah. You gotta...
Ah.
Gotta be careful.
That's, secret that's... tracks.
Oh, I was close, but yeah.
Not quite. And then you get, like, one that'll take you around the whole room.
So I was gonna say, what mad railwayman would create a rail cart that just goes in a circle?
Probably someone who works in a Gungeon.
Probably, yeah.
I would assume. This is a new arcane powder. Okay.
From the deep.
I actually don't know how to switch. Okay, up and there we go. So this will just like cause explosions, basically.
Okay, arcane gunpowder.
Mm-hmm.
Explosions.
What's arcane?
Explosions from the deep.
Oof.
I don't have enough things to do it yet. We'll figure it out.
You got a resource. That's all we know.
All right. Let's see. Looks like we're almost done.
Y'all motherfuckers are used to shallow explosions.
Yeah, but these are deep.
Deep arcane explosions.
Never seen it coming from the deep.
Alright, I think we're almost to the third boss. I don't even know.
Yeah, looks like it.
Because there's random bosses per floor. There's like four or five different ones each floor.
Yeah, they're like chalice dungeons.
Oh, here's this one. Shit. Okay,
hello,
this
friend.
One's tough.
New Sabbat.
Oh man, he's mad!
Fucking
oh, it's
Satan.
Like stuff I used to draw when I was 15.
Cannonball Rog.
That's pretty cool.
Here
like,
we go.
Even if there was flesh on that skull, it would look angry. He was born angry.
He was born this way.
Oof. Wait, no.
What?
Stinger.
Stinger.
Skulls
hate bees.
Look at all the bees on him.
Good damage.
That is actually really good damage. Go for him, my bees!
Not the bees! Not the bees!
Not the bees!
You're basically Oprah. Not the bees! Woolie, do your impersonation of Nicolas Cage in Kick-Ass when he's on the...
Girls! Come on!
It's so bad.
You did it. You did it, Kick-Ass. That guy was so cool in the comics, too.
Yeah.
It's fine, Big Daddy.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
Phase two.
I can only take two more hits.
Good dodge roll.
What the?
I'm trying.
Huh.
You're doing it.
Where are you, buddy?
There
you are.
Yeah, I thought it was there. That
yeah, good there. Distance. Good distance.
Nice miss. Solid Snake wouldn't have missed.
He
would have jump kicked the missile into the air.
It's fine. You're fighting him at your pace.
Yeah. You're setting the stage.
Oh,
oh shit.
Oh.
Yo. The bees got him.
Fuck you, cool guy.
Clutched. That was close.
I'm actually like I'm tearing up a little bit.
That was so close.
Close your eyes.
You're on your last half shell.
We got. I just picked up one though.
Melee shot. Flop.
Okay, what can I refill though? Any more stinger ammo? All right, fourth floor.
Okay. Whoa.
All right. Gotta do it pretty perfect, though.
I'm trying.
Not a lot.
I think there's 6 floors in total. 6 or 5.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not gonna make that. I'll try.
Okay.
I'll try.
You do it. Don't worry about it.
You can refill.
It would have helped if I didn't kill the shopkeeper.
It would have, perhaps.
I didn't think I was gonna last.
Maybe if the height of hubris was not attained, and if you didn't fly so close to the fucking sun.
I just...
Eruption.
I wasn't... I didn't like him. He's not a welcoming
guy. No, it's because you thought this was a disposable video.
No.
Right? Since not on your channel, who gives a fuck?
But you fucked
Oops.
Up.
It turned out to be your best run ever, asshole.
It's true.
You weren't aware that you were this good.
All right, so this guy right here.
You almost fooled us, idiot.
Death right here.
Yeah.
He doesn't go away until you finish the room.
Okay.
You can't kill him. Yeah. But if you
can hide, though.
You can find little chance blocks, like where you can roll the dice.
Chance time.
And then there is a... Oh, this grenade launcher is freaking sick.
It's not bad.
There's a version of death that will follow you through the entirety of the run.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, whatever, that Resident Evil monster?
Nemesis, yeah. Cool. It's like roguelike nemesis for the entirety of life.
I like that a lot.
Wow, that was
Whoa.
Easy.
Coffin cover.
Oh, Jesus!
I gotta find the buff boy. Here he is.
There's a lot going
Get out of here.
A lot going on in this room.
What about this
Everything's
room?
Fine.
Party over here.
Look, this is the party room. Where it's angry Inca face.
I gotta get rid of this buff guy. Okay, he's down.
Buff boy?
The buff boy.
Party over here. Good shots, though.
He made them count.
I don't even have auto-aim on.
Count the gungeon?
There's an auto-aim?
There is an auto-assist feature, yeah.
That would make this game trivialized.
It's still really hard, though.
Is it?
Yeah.
It feels like it would trivialize the game.
Because I tried it with and without when I was at home.
Because you still need to dodge fire, too.
Okay.
Whoa, good stuff.
Oh no!
There's no way to know.
Okay. Oh, see, the bullets are still moving?
Yeah, of course they are.
Super hot.
Exactly, but it gives you time to think.
Super hot is super good.
Sometimes you need a time to think. Super hot, the only game that Buddy deems worthy of playing. Everything. I'm Super Buddy Hop, and this is bullshit.
George is. Quite the stinky fellow, isn't he?
He's a.
No, we're over that.
We're over that?
That arc is over now.
We're on that face.
Yeah.
Phantom George.
Yeah.
Mm. We're now on bunny tendency.
Oh, God.
We gotta send this video to him.
Okay. Fourth level boss is gonna be a little ridiculous, so let's see if I can recoup any of my, my ammo and health.
Heart and a half.
I've never beaten the fourth floor boss.
Well... I'm sure you will without getting hit once.
Today. Expectations, man.
No, yeah. Matt, how impressive was it when he fucking pulled it off? When Austin just beat that game entirely without getting hit?
Dude, it was so easy.
It was amazing.
And he flexed his muscle.
He never got touched.
He never got touched once.
It was the perfect run.
Oh, you gotta stop. Man. You gotta stop.
And then breathless.
And then
I
the developers
it.
Just showed up and were like,
gave him an award.
This was what the game was made for.
For you.
See now, everyone is disappointed.
Yeah, you gotta have
especially my parents.
You have like half
If you've never experienced our next level troll tech, I'd like to welcome you to your perfect run, sir, where you never get touched.
Yeah.
You've already beaten it.
Dead. He's dead.
Oh no.
Gun Reaper.
Dude.
Oh, you know what? You got killed by a Gun Reaper.
That's pretty cool.
The past still haunts you though.
I could have done that if I didn't kill the shopkeeper. That was it.
Yeah.
Oh, but that's
Dude,
you know what?
I'm telling you, like the tech is too strong.
That's it's the way the strong. Dice and the gun rolls.
Jesus Christ.
Now you know it. Now you've learned it. Use it wisely.